Balloons. These stupid balloons that are full of wondrous gold. Literally. They are the key to any seasonal recipe that you're looking for. But man, oh man, can they be your worst enemy? Balloons tied to presents have existed in the Animal Crossing world since the GameCube version. Back then, you had to follow the present through different acres and hope it landed in a tree so you could shake the tree and receive the present. Since Wild World, we've gotten our hands on a slingshot, making the balloon hunting adventure that much more exciting and fruitful. So how do you defeat these beautifully wrapped flying monsters? First, you gotta learn what makes them tick. In New Horizons, balloons spawn over the East or West Ocean every 5 minutes on the 4th and 9th minute. The presents float in the direction that your wind is currently blowing. You can look at the smoke coming from the chimneys of villagers in their homes to see which way your wind is currently blowing. It will blow one way during the day and the opposite way at night. The presents only float east to west rather than north or south. Mostly, there is a way, but I'll get into that in a second. Those are the basics. Pretty simple once you understand how floating presents' brains work. As you've probably noticed, these suckers are each held by a balloon in one of four different colors. Red, blue, yellow, and green. These colors aren't there randomly. Nothing is there randomly in Animal Crossing. You can get almost anything from balloon presents. The five categories are crafting resources, bells, clothing, including shirts, hats, accessories, etc., furniture, and seasonal recipes if we're currently in a specified date where seasonal recipes exist. An easy way to guess what's inside of the present is based off the balloon color. The chances of finding an item from a specific category are listed on the Animal Crossing Wiki. They've done the work for us. Though they use fractions like 14th out of 45 and 11th out of 45. So to make it easier, I converted it into percentages and put it in a Google Doc. Now this isn't 100% accurate about what I'm about to say. The wiki has all of the specific chances. But based on my own 6 hours of balloon hunting and months of having these things fly over my head, I have noticed that red balloons have a better chance of containing clothing, blue a better chance of crafting resources, yellow bells, and green furniture. Seasonal recipes when available can be found in any balloon color. Crafting resources can only appear in the blue balloons, and bells can only appear in the yellow balloons. During my testing, the blue balloon was the most common by far. And man, oh man, did I get a lot of clay. If you want the exact percentages that the wiki lists and the results from my own testing, those are both in the Google Doc that's linked in the description. Recipes seem to be the most sought after item from balloons, since the only other way to get them is by villagers crafting in their house. There is a 15% chance of receiving a new recipe and a 5% chance that you'll get a duplicate recipe. In the 6 hours I spent balloon hunting specifically for this video, I only got a duplicate recipe twice. Every other time I received a recipe, it was new. And I still missed a mushroom recipe. Am I going to remember that I need to find the mushroom parasol recipe by the time November comes around again? Nope! The wiki also lists percent chances for specific items like bells, gold, and iron to drop from balloons. There is some weird stuff about balloons that I didn't know about until doing research. Like the percent chance of certain items appearing depends on whether or not you've already seen 10 floating presents for the day. Like before, it's 1% chance, and then after, it like flip-flops to a different chance. It's weird. I didn't know presents could count. The percent chances also change based on whether or not seasonal recipes are currently available, and if you have yet to learn these new recipes. It's the game's way of giving you a better chance to find the new recipes, and as a result, decreases the chance of finding the other items that fly through the sky. The percentages for an item to show up are not based on the specific color of balloon. They are the percent chances that the game spawns them in general. So it's not a, if you have a yellow balloon, there's a 25% chance that it'll be a 1000 bell bag. Instead, it's for every balloon that spawns, there is a 25% chance that that item will be 1000 bells. Now that we know about spawn rates, what's the best way to find them? If you're anything like me, you've ran up and down your beach every 4th and 9th minute, but can't seem to find the floating present. There's a couple, tricks? They're not tricks, but I can't think of a better word for them, that can aid you in successfully spawning and popping as many balloons as possible. The first is the balloon timer. Thank you, creator Ray PS. You've saved me from running around my island trying to find these balloons like crazy. This website, which I've also linked below, will show you about where your present is on your island. All you have to do is compare where the flashing line is located on the gridded island template to your own map and find where the balloon is on your island. Do keep in mind though, while balloons spawn on the 4th and 9th minute, they take almost a full minute to actually reach your beach. The timer is an amazing gauge of when the balloon will arrive at your beach. The website allows you to change your wind direction as well, so make sure you're looking at the chimneys to see which way your wind is blowing. If you're like me, you've had the issue with balloons just not spawning sometimes. There are times I've run up and down the beach for a solid 30 seconds. There's no balloon and it seems impossible that you missed one. Side note, what the heck? Why do the waves in the ocean sound eerily similar to the wind? I'm always convincing myself I hear a present and run around like a maniac just finding nothing. There is an assumption that you must reset the map by entering a building in between balloons to get them to spawn consistently. This has worked for me. In Animal Crossing, whenever you enter a building and exit, all of the randomly spawned mechanics like fish, bugs, creatures, and yes, even balloons, reset. It all changes. From my own experience of chilling on the beach for an hour, versus spending an hour entering and exiting buildings in between each balloon, the resetting of the map worked to spawn more balloons. Keep in mind that the balloons spawn on the 4th and 9th minute, so if you are entering buildings, make sure you exit before the 4th or 9th minute to make sure your balloon doesn't disappear on you. Someone linked me this awesome Reddit post which talks about placing either jail bars or climbing walls to force the present to fly to a specific area on your map, which seems weird. But if you've searched for enough balloons, you've probably noticed that presents don't fly over specific areas, like resident services. The Reddit user let us know that if you stack a straight line of climbing walls or jail bars, the presents are unable to fly over them. So if you create a gap in the walls, the present will travel to the gap and then will proceed to fly across the island. It's a little difficult for those of us with an east or west river mouth. Even when creating a temporary bridge, there's still a large gap that is pretty much impossible to eliminate. So keep an eye out for the specific area when you're present hunting. Basically, the strategy is line up all the walls and keep less than a half square of space between them, because a present cannot fly in a half square of space. I tried the wall strategy, and I was able to shoot down more presents than ever. It's a great way to ensure that a present doesn't fly by you without you noticing. This process does have a trying to make a rock garden by putting mannequins everywhere vibe to it, but if you're missing a few seasonal recipes and it's the end of the month, it's totally worth setting up. It also allows you to chill in one spot and let the presents come to you. You own them, let them know it. On a side note, balloons do not spawn when you have friends over to your island. I've also witnessed balloons having a hard time spawning when your gates are open. They still spawn, but it's really inconsistent. Seeing a balloon float by is one of the most exciting parts of my day in Animal Crossing. They add that little extra ooh ooh when you randomly hear it whoosh by and you're running around your island. I've loved these since the beginning, and I hope they never go away, no matter how frustrating they can be sometimes. What's your strategy when balloon hunting? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you next time. Bye!